friends, in the last class we were talking on the preparation of alkyl halides. Our starting material was alcohols. Okay, we were using the halogen acid as our reagents. The reaction of alcohols with halogen acid was discussed to be nucleophilic substitution reactions, where the halide ions were the nucleophiles. This was the substrate molecule, right? Today we will find some example. We will take example for the preparation of tertiary alkyl halides, secondary alkyl halides and primary alkyl halide. In order to prepare tertiary alkyl halide, let us consider tertiary butyl alcohol be the substrate. When that we treated one of the halogen acid, we will get the corresponding tertiary butyl halide. This is your tertiary butyl alcohol molecule. Let us consider concentrated HCl as our hydrohalic acid, the reagent here. The reaction of halogen acid with the tertiary alcohols, it occurs smoothly even at room condition, 25 degrees Celsius. Then the corresponding product is tertiary butyl chloride along with the formation of the water molecule. Okay, this is tertiary butyl alcohol and this is your tertiary butyl chloride. If we try to explain the mechanism of this reaction, this is SnO1 reaction. As I've told you, tertiary alcohols, secondary alcohols, benzylic alcohols, allylic alcohols, this kind of substrate molecule, they undergo SnO1 reaction. That means the reaction involves the formation of a carbocation intermediate, right? Here the leaving group is OH. OH minus is one of the weaker leaving groups, as it is one of a strong base. The leaving ability of this group, that must be lower. In order to increase the leaving ability, this HCl, that will help it. In the first step, this tertiary butyl alcohol molecule, that will be protonated. This is your alcohol molecule, it is the reagent. This HCl, it will protonate it. Alcohol molecule will be protonated, such that you will get protonated alcohol. Protonated alcohol passed. This is the Cl minus. Soon after the formation of this protonated alcohol species, the hydrolysis will start, resulting in the formation of a carbocation intermediate, along with the release of one water molecule. This water molecule, this molecule will be released, and you will get the carbocation intermediate species. This is your carbocation. And the remaining species Cl minus, which will act the nucleophile in the next step. This is your first step. In the second step, Cl minus, that will attack this carbocation species. This is your carbocation, this is the nucleophilic species, it will attack this carbon, resulting in the formation of the final product, tertiary butyl chloride. Okay. Similarly, tertiary butyl bromide or tertiary butyl iodide, that can be prepared by using SBR, concentrated hydrobromic acid, concentrated hydroiodic acid. Okay. Similarly, we can prepare secondary alkyl halides in order to obtain secondary alkyl halide. We need the secondary alcohol as the starting material. Suppose I need to prepare secondary alkyl bromide. For example, I'm taking secondary butyl alcohol as the substrate molecule. This is secondary butyl alcohol. When it be treated with concentrated HBr, in the presence of a catalyst, little amount of concentrated H2SO4 that could be used here, and when this reaction mixture be heated, you will get the corresponding product. This is secondary butyl bromide plus water. Secondary butyl bromide. This reaction that undergoes SN1 mechanism. Okay. Similarly, if I will take N-butyl alcohol as my substrate molecule, another point is to be noted here. I can use SBr directly, or SBr can be generated in the reaction medium when a mixture of NaBr and concentrated H2SO4 be taken. Sodium bromide or potassium bromide and concentrated H2SO4. When these two species that be treated with alcohol, these two species will react and they will generate HBr, and right after the formation of the HBr, the reaction will occur with this alcohol molecule in the same way, and the final product that would be CH3CH2 CH2CH2Br plus water. Okay, this NaBr and concentrated H2SO4, they will react in the reaction medium giving rise to NaHSO4, sodium hydrogen sulfate, and HBr. This HBr that will act as the further reagent which will react with this alcohol to form the product. This is your primary alcohol, and as I told you, this primary alcohols here, they will undergo a reaction through SN2 mechanism. Okay. Similarly, if I need to prepare alkyl iodide, for example, isopropyl alcohol, we have a starting material that we treated with HI. In the place of HBr, I have taken HI. A little amount of catalyst is to be used here. The catalyst is S3PO4. When this reaction mixture is heated, you will get the corresponding iodide CH3CH3I, isopropyl iodide, to be the formation of water molecule. Okay. Similarly, I can take one of the primary alcohol as the substrate molecule. When that be treated with HI, I will get the corresponding alkyl iodide. HI can be generated in situ in the reaction medium, like HBr. However, just you need to note here, in order to prepare HI in the reaction medium, I need to use NaI or KI, sodium iodide or potassium iodide, but I cannot use concentrated H2SO4 here. I need to use S3PO4, phosphoric acid, such that NaH2PO4 and HI will be formed, and this HI that will react with the alcohol substrate in order to form the final product. A question is there, why exactly S3PO4 that is to be taken instead of H2SO4? If I take H2SO4 here, the reaction will occur. The reaction will occur. Suppose Na(I) it be treated with H2SO4. Okay. Then I could get NaHSO4 plus acyl. However, the acyl, it is one of the powerful reducing agent, and H2SO4, it is one of the oxidizing agent. This powerful reducing agent, it undergoes oxidation readily. In the presence of this concentrated H2SO4, this HI molecule, that will be oxidized into I2. This HI molecule, it will be oxidized into I2. That's why, in order to prevent the further oxidation, I cannot use this oxidizing acid here. I need to use S3PO4, one of the non-oxidizing acid. Okay. If I take secondary alcohol, then the reaction, that would be through SN1 mechanism. And if I use primary alcohol as my substrate molecule, then the reaction would be through SN2 mechanism. Okay. So this was about the preparation of secondary and primary alkyl bromide or alkyl iodide. If I need to prepare secondary alkyl chloride or primary alkyl chloride, I need to use HCl as the reagent. But the thing is that the reactions of primary or secondary alcohols with concentrated HCl is very, very slow. If I use certain Lewis acid like anhydrous zinc chloride as the catalyst, then the reaction that would be occurred smoothly. What have I told you? Just to prepare primary or secondary alkyl chloride, I need to use HCl. Let us consider one of the secondary alcohol as the substrate molecule here. This is your alcohol molecule. When it be treated with concentrated HCl in the presence of anhydrous zinc chloride, this mixture is to be used. A mixture of HCl and anhydrous zinc chloride, that is called as the Lucas reagent. Then your product would be CS3, CS2, CS, CS3, Cl plus water. In the similar way, we can predict about the mechanism. This is the secondary alcohol. Then the mechanism, that would be through SN1 pathway. Okay. If I would use the primary alcohol as the substrate molecule, then the mechanism of the reaction, that would be through SN2 mechanism. Okay. Here, the zinc chloride molecule that coordinates this oxygen of alcohol in order to increase the living ability of this living group. If we talk about the mechanism here, CH3, CH2, CH, CH3, OH, this is your alcohol molecule. Before the reaction with HCl, this zinc chloride, anhydrous zinc chloride, this is one of the Lewis acid, strong Lewis acid, that will coordinate this alcohol molecule such that you will get fast CH3, CH2, CH, CH3, OH, ZnCl2. This intermediate will form fast. Okay. Partial negative charge will be formed here, partial positive charge will be formed here. Okay. The coordination of this zinc chloride with this oxygen that weakens this carbon oxygen bond, it means it increases, it enhances the living ability of this OH. As this secondary alcohol substrate molecule, as I told you, the reaction is through SN1 mechanism. Now the heterolytic cleavage of this bond will occur, leading to the formation of the carbocation. The secondary carbocation CH3, CH2, CH, CH3 plus. This is your carbocation, along with the formation of the side stresses HO, ZnCl2 minus. Okay. Then the nucleophile, I have used here HCl, that will provide Cl minus, which will use as the nucleophile. So carbocation formed here is CH3CH2, CHCH3. This is your carbocation, and Cl minus from HCl, it will attack this carbon center, giving rise to the final product CH3, CH2, CH, CH3, Cl. Secondary butyl chloride, that would be our final product, and H plus, which is from HCl, that will interact with the side stresses formed in the previous stage, giving rise to the water molecule along with the regeneration of ZnCl2. In this way, this reaction occurs. Here I have taken secondary alcohol, I can use primary alcohol. If I use primary alcohol, then the mechanism would be through SN2 pathway. This mixture HCl plus ZnCl2, this is called as Lucas reagent, and this method of preparation of primary alkyl chloride and secondary alkyl chloride by using this Lucas reagent, that is called as groups process, groups method. Thank you.